in, and we're just about set to kick off. And now let's head down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams have sent their special teams out of the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. And down he goes at the 24-yard line. Alabama's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brett, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
He's taken down around the 37-yard line.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
And he just gets rid of it. From their own 37-yard line, second down. At about the 45. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, it's a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
And he tackles him hard at the 46-yard line.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
First and 10. Ball on the 46. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's brought down in the open field.
What we're seeing right now is just a great connection between the quarterback and his receivers. They make these plays look effortless.
Just throws this one away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
Now, that time the defense brought some pressure and the quarterback was able to execute and still get the first down. I still think the defense has got to maintain that aggressive nature. They can't get away from it and get passive just because they gave up the first down in that play.
Has all day to throw. Deep pass to the end zone. Touchdown time.
They looked awesome on that play. A well-thrown football and a great effort to get the ball into the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. An 8-play, 76-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. The score now, 7-0. They line up to kick this one away. It's fielded at the 2. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 23. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds. Yeah. with room to work. And he's level at the 47. Quick pass. And they make the stop around the 28-yard line.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route. Good protection and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
And he's tackled around the 27-yard line. The 24-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards.
Quick.
That'll make it 35.
Quick strike to the receiver. And he is drilled at the 10-yard line. First and goal, and a touchdown ties it, folks. Five wide. And down he goes, right around the 8-yard line. Touchdown, Hoosiers. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he tacks on the extra point. Indiana is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 30. This offense did really well with the air attack on their last trip out there. Let's see if they can do the same thing here.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing and how to attack a defense. And right now, these wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job of being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback put the ball right on the money.
Second and 10. Ball on their own 30. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Gets it out to his receiver, and he can't hang on.
Well, the defense did all there.
Well, the defense did what they had to do to get three and out and now get the offense back on the field.
And he's taken down at the 49-yard line. The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
Steps out of bounds at the 47-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 on that play. That makes it 7-6.
Quick that ball. Mike Schick, 33. 33.
They'll bring him down at about the 47-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That's good for 7 yards. First down.
finds his way to the 30-yard line. Quick throw to the tight end. Tackle made at the 14. And he's taken down at the 13-yard line. We've played one quarter. We're even at 7 in this one. Set to resume action here in quarter number 2. Deadlock after the first 15 minutes. Quick to an open man, he dropped it. Here's the 8th play of the series. Looking for his man, incomplete. It's 4th down. They'll line it up for the field goal. Indiana is looking to go up by 3. It's up, and it is good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Fielded at the 9. He's out to the 30, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 36-yard line.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Inside give. Excellent open field tackle. From their own 38-yard line, it's 2nd down. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. And that one's incomplete. Pushed out of bounds around the 39-yard line.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Indiana is up by 3. He scrambled. Brought down
right around the 46-yard line.
That's a game of 7. That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
He fires left side. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
Brad, he drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
3rd down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the 1st down. Makes it to the 44. He's out of bounds around the 40-yard line.
That makes it 7-6.
Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that.
Number 6.
scrambling. He's wrapped up for the sack.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
Indiana has a three-point lead. No good on fourth down. So they turn it over on downs, and that's a big boost for this defense.
In a close game like this one, it's big plays like this that can be the deciding factor.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Gets to about the 44-yard line. From their own 44-yard line. Second down. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's taken down at the 46. To about the 34-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 34. Gets out to about the 31. And a halfback carries for a pickup of three.
You have to like how this linebacker was able to move up quickly and bring down the ball carrier for a short gain. Nice stop by the junior.
To the end zone. He caught it for the touchdown. He makes the PAT. It was a 5-play, 59-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So the score now, 14-10. He'll return it from the three. Brought down at the 29.
Well, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, the other gets right back into it. This is exciting.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He's scrambling. Tackle at about the 31. He scrambled, but he didn't get much.
Brad, this defense reacts too quickly for a scramble like that to work. He needs to spread him out a little bit more to try to create more room to run.
Throws it in a hurry. And they make the stop at the 47. Tries to buy some time, and they got it.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
From their own 45-yard line, it's second down. He's on the run. Now he's going to run and watch out. Slides down. 7-yard pickup on the scramble by the quarterback. Indiana is going to have to use their second time out of the half. Scrambling around. Decides to slide.
Check three.
He's looking for six. Oh, and he can't hold on. From the 36-yard line, second down. He's going to try and scramble. And he's tackled at the 26. He scrambled. Slides down to the ground.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. He flings it left. That's incomplete.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
The field goal unit's out on the field, and they're going to try to get these guys 3 points before halftime. He gets it up, and they tack on 3 points. They're probably just going to squib this kick. I don't think they want to see the return man create lightning before halftime. Caught at the 8. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. Folks, that's the end of the first half, and this game's getting interesting. 14-13, Crimson Tide.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. He's Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like it is going to be a great second half. And, boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
I can only hope that Nessler and Herbstreit will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Fires out to his receiver. He's tackled right around the 38-yard line. It fly, and he's got the junior touchdown. The wide receiver flew down the field on that touchdown connection.
Well, he has the speed to stretch the defense, and his hands are getting better every single game.
And they're looking to get 2 points here. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide out look. They don't get it.
Well, it didn't work out here, but I won't fault the coaches for going for two. This is a situation where you need the points.
Indiana gets set to kick this one away.
Number eight.
He'll return it from the six. And down he goes at the 23.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
He heaves it deep. On the reception, look out. Nobody there. To the 20. And down he goes.
Around the 8-yard line.
The big pickup through the air has made it first and goal. They give to the tailback. Runs outside for a nice game. Left and he'll lose yardage.
That makes it third and goal.
So here it is, crucial third down as they try to take the lead.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
Kicks away, and it sails through the uprights.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Alabama is ready to kick it away. He's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Alabama's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
This offense did really well with the air attack on their last trip out there. Let's see if they can do the same thing here.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
Indiana with a two-point advantage. And he throws it away. That looked like the same play they just called.
Yeah, it was. The defense was ready for it this time.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 42. They'll bring him down at the 49-yard line.
That's a gain of nine on the play. Third down.
Hey, we got to get to the ball, D. We got to get to the ball. Let's keep moving.
Yeah, yeah. Wait, wait. It's 87.
Motion.
Line 87.
Now he's scrambling. And he's taken down around the 48-yard line. So he keeps it and picks up maybe a yard on the play.
That makes it
looks good. Like they're going to go for it on fourth down. He's scrambling. And he tackles him hard at the 40-yard line. Tackle made right around the 32-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
Tries to buy some time. They bring him down.
That'll bring up third and two.
Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start. Offense.
They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're still in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30. Indiana holds just a two-point lead. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receiver. He let that pass get away from him.
I think he's a little bit anxious. He actually looked a little bit too juiced that time, but he'll get the next one.
He's on the run. And he is drilled at the 37-yard line. Huge play for the defense. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he's tackled after positive yardage. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Complete. He's got room. He goes out of bounds at the 48-yard line. That makes it first and 10. On the run. Taken down as he works the left for a nice game.
That brings him second and 5.
From the 47-yard line, it's second down.
Mike's 42! Mike's 42! Go!
Looks middle, got his back. Brought down around the 46-yard line. Yards away here on third down. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. And he's level at the 37. This looks like it could come down to the very end. Indiana's leading by 2. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Pulls in the pass and steps out. It's complete for about 4 yards and a first down.
This quarterback still hasn't missed a receiver on this drive.
From the 26-yard line, first down. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards. This is the 9th play of this drive. They knock him out before he can get back to the original line of scrimmage. And this is the 10th play of the drive. Taken down at the 17-yard line. They'll call on the field goal unit here. Kicks up, and it is good. And so they take the lead with that field goal.
Big time kick late in the game. That was a clutch kick to put them up on top.
Alabama kicked this one off. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 22. I have a feeling we haven't seen the end of the fireworks today.
Well, there's a reason the offenses and quarterbacks work on the two-minute drill 12 months out of the year. It's for opportunities like this to be aware of things like how many timeouts are left, how much time is on the clock, whether or not your receiver gets inbounds or gets out of bounds. You constantly have to be aware of all the things that go into building a good two-minute offense. Right now, by just being down by a couple points, you got a chance to win this game with a field goal.
Gets to around the 42. Midfield makes it to the 47. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That makes it second and six.
And they make the stop right around the 30. Less than 3 minutes in the game. It's the tailback. Makes it to the 21. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. On the delay, inside the 10, tackle at the 7.
That makes it first and goal.
Nearly intercepted. Second down and goal. Ball on the 7. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete. 10th play of the drive. Run there as they work the outside. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. The kick is up, and he's got it. Indiana to kick. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. Alabama's coaches have got to be confident in the fact that they've got a star player in a tight situation.
And there's nothing better than having a quarterback you have confidence in these kind of situations. You know he's going to make the right read. He's going to give his receivers a chance to make a play on the ball. And they're going to have a really good chance of moving the ball down the field to have a shot to win this game. Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions, especially when the defense defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 46-yard line. From their own 46-yard line, it's first down. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Short pass, middle of the field, and he's tackled at the 45.
That brings him second and one.
Quick strike to the receiver. He's tackled around the 38-yard line. From the 38-yard line, first down. Just throws this one away. Quick out to his receiver. He's knocked out of bounds at the 16-yard line. From the 16-yard line, first down. Makes it out to maybe the 13-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Tackle just sealed the deal. A great one to win, a really tough one to lose. Indiana 22, Alabama 20. That brings this broadcast to a close. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.